find today is a very interesting evening of literature, and it is not. Of a novelist, who is not. And of a travel saga, which it is not again. Please take your seats and let's begin to discover what this evening is all about and what it is not. Allow me to present this evening to you. I am Ujjwal, Professor Ujjwal Kumar Chaudhary, and I am currently setting up a university dedicated to media, design, entertainment and art in the world's largest film city. Any guess? Ramoji Film City, Hyderabad, as its first Vice Chancellor. I consider myself extremely lucky and privileged to present this evening to you. Also privileged because I am presenting this evening to you from my good friend Mr. M.P. Joseph. The world looks for easy answers and easy to make nomenclature. Welcome the guests on the dais before taking the evening forward. I request Mr. M.P. Joseph to usher the special guests of the evening onto the dais. I have the pleasure of inviting the distinguished guests on dais, please. The distinguished parliamentarian, chairman of the Parliamentary Committee of External Affairs, former Union Minister of External Affairs, Government of India, Under Secretary General and the Head of Communication in the United Nations, social media aficionado, how can I forget that, and a writer of tremendous eminence himself, Mr. Shashi Tharoor. Well, actually, he needs no introduction, Mr. Shashi Tharoor. I am also the pleasure to invite on stage the Honorable Justice Mr. Kurian Joseph, Justice of the highest seat of judiciary in India, the Supreme Court. Justice Kurian, please. And Mr. Joseph, would you kindly take your chairs?
Justice, please.
Okay, fine. Please take your chairs, please. Before I introduce the book, I must tell you that the world looks for very, very easy answers, you know, nomenclatures, whether it's for places, ideas, people, books, events. So you are either conservative or modern, very easy to place. An idealist or a realist, a democrat or a fascist or a Marxist, a feminist or a chauvinist. Mind searches for stereotypes, and as it is easy to put people in places, people and places or ideas in boxes. Interestingly, what it is, if you cannot put a work of literature and person in such an easy box. Today we have a piece of literature that will be unveiled very soon in front of us, which is neither a fiction nor a travelogue in a classical sense.
It's quite an unusual book to present to you this evening, because what M.P. Joseph has done is write a book that is, as Dr. Chaudhary said, neither a travelogue, nor really a novel, nor just a collection of vignettes, nor a selection of short stories, but somehow manages to incorporate the features of all of these in one single volume, and does so with a tremendous amount of wit and quite an impressive collection of insights. What is extremely unusual about this book, and I stress the unusualness of it because I don't think any of us has ever read anything like it, is that it seems to begin as a straightforward memoir, then moves into fictional terrain, but instead of, as novels tend to do, just telling a story, it breaks into a lot of interesting observations and sidelights about Cambodia that might belong in a travelogue or even an analysis of a country that you might see. So we've got all of these genres coexisting within the covers of this book, but not coexisting uneasily. In fact, what's quite remarkable about M.P. Joseph's achievement here is that he manages to keep you engaged through the anecdotes, the storyline, the insights, the observations, the commentary, and at the same time manages to teach you something as you go along. I'm assuming that there's a lot of autobiography in the book. As Mr. Joseph's remarks at the beginning of this evening have made very, very clear, he has himself served in Cambodia, fallen in love with the country, and a lot of that comes through. But he's also kept a certain slightly droll eye on what he sees and has seen around him, and the characters that he has created to populate his book, I think, are vehicles for conveying to you some of those insights.